understanding that the only thing that he had to answer to God with was to make sure that he kept the law. But Jesus Christ goes further than that. He doesn't just say, just commit fornication with your body. But he says, if you look upon a woman and you lust after her, you committed adultery with that woman. You've done it in your heart. Your intentions. Yes, we watch our actions, but what about our intentions? Do we weigh our intentions? And do we understand that God sees them and he sees the desires of our heart? We are bought with a price. And what is that price? 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 18 and 19 tells us, "For as much as you know that ye were not redeemed with corruptible things as silver and gold from your vain conversation received by traditions from your fathers, but with the precious blood of Christ as of a lamb without blemish and without spot." He says, listen, you were not purchased with money. You were not purchased with anything that this world considers valuable. But you were purchased with the blood of God's own Son, shed from the veins of the Creator, which the Bible tells us represent life. The blood is the life of an animal. The blood in the blood is a life of a human. Christ bled for us. He gave his life, shed on that cross, to be purchased a people who were slaves to sin, dominated by the devil in darkness, and brought us to the status of sons, adopted children, heirs of the kingdom of God. And the reason why we purify our bodies is not because God's going to punish us, but because his holiness is inside of us. Because we are precious to him. Because our bodies are special. And what are one of the wonderful promises that come with being the temple of God? Look what the scripture tells us in Romans chapter 8, verse 11. "But if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his spirit that dwelleth in you." Because our bodies are the temple of God. When we die, when our bodies, our physical bodies pass away, there will come a day where God will raise us up again. And this should give us incredible courage, knowing that even though we die, though we may lose our lives, either through sickness, either through accident, either through natural death, or as martyrs, as many Christians have in history and are being martyred today, that the life is not in their hands. That because we believed and trusted in Christ, that we will be raised again. Our bodies will not become ashes, or will not stay ashes. Our bodies will be resurrected, just as Jesus Christ rose from the grave. You see, in ancient times, past civilizations would raise up elaborate temples, at least incredible buildings that would be used to represent the glory of their kingdoms. But God, in this age, through the death and resurrection of his Son Jesus Christ, has chosen to make his temple and his people so that we can live for the glory of God.
Amen. Like my brother Javer mentioned, from Moses it went to David, and his son Samuel built God a temple. And lastly, we see in the book of Revelation, chapter 11, verse 14 through 19, that the Word of God says, and the seven angels sounded his trumpet. And there were loud voices in heaven which said, the kingdom of the world has become the kingdom of our Lord and of his Messiah. And he will reign forever and ever. Again, we see that now our Lord and Savior and King has taken reign over the world. And in verse 16, the word said, and the 24 elders who were seated on their throne before God fell on their faces and worshiped God. Verse 17, saying, we give thanks to you, Lord God Almighty, the one who is and who was, because you have taken your great power and have begun to reign. Verse 18, the nations were angry, and your wrath has come. The time has come for judging the dead and for rewarding your servant, the prophet, and your people who receive your name. Brothers and sisters, there is going to be a day of judgment. Whether you like it or not, it's going to happen. God sent his son Jesus to come and die on a cross for all our sins and to pay our price. You could receive it or you could reject it. But if you reject it, there are consequences, and the consequences are death. But for those of us who accept Jesus Christ, there are promises. Promises that God has made to each and every one. And we could find that in the book of John 14:2. And it says, in my house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would not have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. That is a wonderful God, who even though since the beginning, we betrayed him, we've spoken about him, we turned our back against him, we have sinned against our God, he is preparing a place for us. But brothers and sisters, like I mentioned before on many other programs, grace is not a license to sin. And that's why God, in the book of 1 Peter 1:6, it says, for it is written, be holy because I am holy. And that is such a big thing, brothers and sisters, when it comes to Christianity. Because everybody in the world is looking at us, at the people who claim to be God's temple. And how can they respect God or believe in God if we are living in sin and filth? If we are teaching corrupt scriptures? If we are manipulating the people? If we are stealing and robbing from the sheep? This is something, brothers and sisters, that God is against, and we should not be involved in it. Father God, tonight we want to thank you. We want to thank you, Father, for your grace. We want to thank you, Father, for loving us so much that you created such a wonderful place in Eden for us. And yet that we sinned against you, you forgave us and came down from heaven to pay the price for us, for our sins, to give us your Holy Spirit so that you can dwell in us, Father, so that we could communicate back with you and walk with you and later go to heaven to prepare our home. We thank you for this, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. We thank you for listening tonight. We apologize for any thunder that you may hear in the microphones. There's actually a bit of a thunderstorm going on. So we apologize for that. But we hope that you've enjoyed tonight's broadcast. It is a very serious one. It's a privilege to know that God has made his home inside of us and amongst his people. And that's why we should take this as a very serious exhortation for us to examine our lives and think before we make specific decisions, to understand that this body that we have, that we are given, does not belong to us. It belongs to God. Thank you again. We hope that it's been a blessing to you. Remember, you can visit us at our webpage, redemptionandpower.com. You can also contact us either by email, redemptionandpower@gmail.com, or through our Facebook page, or by phone at 305-320-RRAP. That's 305-320-7727. Thank you again for listening. We pray that the Lord bless you.
Yes, Lord. Blessing and honor.
Blessing and honor. Glory and power. Riches and wisdom and strength. Blessing and honor. Riches and wisdom and strength be unto.